getting on the road just outside of the Baton Rouge, Louisiana area. How should we say that? Baton Rouge. Sorry, shouldn't try accents. Yeah, I should. I'm not bad at them. And we're beaconing. As soon as I get stable on the highway here, I'm going to dial in the SouthCars net. Boy, am I in the south. 7251. Let's see if they're on the air. Alpha Quebec, Mobile. That was not a successful attempt to check in. That net control for SouthCars is in Virginia, which is, you know, in the south, sort of. But it's not very strong, so the band's not in good shape out that direction. So tell you what, while we're waiting for SouthCars to come around to take in check-ins again, let's do an excursion around the band. It's 10:40 in the morning, you know, a time of day when 40 meters is about as local as it gets, a few hundred miles. So plenty of big signals out there. So the band is not dead, apparently.
Yeah, you know,
signals are just not on SouthCars. All right, let's see what 20 meters is doing. Send the antenna that direction. WWV 10 megahertz as we cross that spectrum, and as the antenna goes by, it is not looking too great. Got WWV at 15 megahertz up here somewhere. Oh, WWV at 20 megahertz is strong, even with my antenna at 14 megahertz. And at 15 megahertz is very strong. So 20 ought to be in pretty good shape. Let's go find out. Well, in Asian language, I certainly can't identify it. The signals are strong. If that's coming out of Asia, those are some of the strongest Asian signals I've heard in the car ever. Rarely hear anything strong, but I kind of suspect they're more domestic and people practicing their whatever language that is. I think I heard him say D-Star. log slow scan. There's always something going on 14230.
VW, you're on your three times with that same picture.
Now that frequency is normally a digital slow scan, and I think although the guy's on sideband, he's talking about pictures.
That's at 1 foot above my roof line.
You know, I kind of miss K1MAN. Is entertaining. There isn't room on HF for a whole lot of people to run 24-hour-a-day bulletin. And even if it was a totally legit bulletin deal without a lot of attitude to it. And I'm not saying that attitude is a problem. I certainly display a bit of that in my programs. More construction. But I wonder if there'd be a way. I can listen to Newsline and all that stuff on the internet. That's not a problem. But having it on the radio is kind of interesting. And there were times when K1MAN was running Newsline or some other bulletin service that it was kind of fun to listen to. It could even run my audio for most of the programs. And he didn't get tagged for that kind of thing because it's not illegal. The rules are kind of vague on what you can do in terms of one-way transmissions, but there's no time limit on that bulletins of interest to the general ham radio population. I think he got caught for things like no control operator present and stuff like that. So, again, we don't need a whole lot of them, but it might be kind of fun to have one or three on some bands. I don't know. Maybe the problems engendered by getting a lot of it would outweigh the value of having any of it at all. Anyway, he's gone.
Tango Whiskey. I guess everybody went to lunch. You're 5'9", New Mexico. Which is a two-lane blacktop on the 66 between the towns. It runs through its Main Street here in Grants.
I've been through there, I was going to say many times. It's probably half a dozen at least, well, more like a dozen back and forth across I-40.
Well, not too much on 66,
Grants, New Mexico.
But those tip signs, you better believe it.
So I'm not hearing any DX. Everything's sounding pretty domestic.
Frank with John, our vice commander. Let's go out to Jerry in Gig Harbor. K4LAP, Jerry, it's your turn, over.
W3XAF from K4LAP, a good copy this morning. Good copy on everybody from the Pacific Northwest. This morning at breakfast, I was reading the New York Times newspaper, the Sunday edition.
Because he's out there doing something he really shouldn't be doing. And boy, then he pays us pretty handsome.
This would be the County Hunters net.
Anyone else? Caldwell, DeKalb, Missouri.
WA9DLB.
WA9DLB, go.
Jerry, 2-2-2-2-2-2.
Minimum, over.
Over.
I'm here to 2-2. Yes, you are.
Okay, one, two.
My friend Jerry, KE4TTS, has been out on a longer cross-country than me, way out to the west, and he's on his way back. Might get a chance to talk to him today. He's a county hunter, and he's been stopping at many of those out-of-the-way counties, particularly sitting on a county line where his contact with him counts for two counties. I want to do a show on this sometime if I find some people to talk to.
All right, 1555, last call, please.
1555, thank you. This is KE4TTS, county line DeKalb and
Caldwell in Missouri. Last call, QRZ.
Kilo November 4, Alpha Quebec.
KN4AQ, 5555, Gary.
55 to Jerry.
Got the 5, QRZ. Anybody else for
I was hoping that would be Jerry, and there it was.
Last call, QRZ. Don't hear any more, Jim. Thank you very much. I'll call you when I get to the next one.
They might yell at me for using phonetics. You're not supposed to.
Thank you very much.
That was KU4TTS, Caldwell on DeKalb, Missouri. More to come. K2JG,
a radio change. Follow me. There we go. Yeah, I drifted a little bit, but now it's 7251. At this time, I'm taking check-ins from mobile stations only. Mobile stations only for SouthCars. Suffix, phonetically, call now.
Alpha, Quebec.
Was that Papa Lima Bravo mobile? I'll be putting out a general call next. Any relays on mobile stations?
Alpha Quebec, Mobile.
Alpha Quebec Romeo, are you a relay or are you mobile?
I am a Mobile Alpha Quebec Mobile.
Alpha Quebec Mobile, got you in there solid. Good signal, please come aboard.
Okay, of course, a semi-trailer pulled right next to me as I was trying to check in and shot the standing wave on the Tar Heel antenna through the roof, but it has pulled ahead of me. It wants to go faster than me. Kilowatt November 4, Alpha Quebec. My name is Gary. I am mobile on Interstate 10 on the other side of Lake Pontchartrain from New Orleans. And I am heading toward Raleigh, North Carolina. I am not going to get there today. Expect to get about as far as Montgomery, Alabama, maybe a little bit farther. And on my way back from Austin, Texas, from the Tapper Digital Communications Conference. And I do not consider it to be an official cross-country day unless I have managed to check into one of the mobile service nets. And of course, being here in Louisiana, that's got to be SouthCars. My number is 1-872-1872, or oh God help me for saying this, $18.72. It is already 91 degrees and mostly sunny, but some big puffy white clouds out there. Back to you, KN4AQ Mobile. My name's Gary.
Gary, outstanding signal from near Lake Pontchartrain. I know that area well. Good S5 or better on you. Really good signal. Near New Orleans, Louisiana, Jerry's trying to go home. Got a long way to go. Probably won't get there tonight. 91 degrees, mostly sunny, and I bet there's a lot of humidity, too. 1872, not only is Jerry's number, it's when he graduated high school. Jerry is Kilo November 4 Alpha Quebec Mobile. How about that, Jerry? We all good?
Except for the name. We'll change it to Gary Golf Alpha Romeo Yankee, and then we are good, and you guys entertain me for a few more miles. KN4AQ Mobile.
Roger, roger. I made the correction, Gary. Thank you, sir.
73.
Is this SouthCars, the South Coast Amateur Radio Service? My call sign is N4GUV. And the name is Bill Bravio. Bravio, India Lima Lima. I talk funny and look even worse.
W4FT. W4FT, KN4AQ. Can you hear me now?
KN4AQ.
W4FT, go ahead.
Still in a forest of trucks. I'm going to get past this truck and I will fine-tune my antenna. Okay, the antenna is happier. Can you hear me now?
Yes, I can, but you dropped to about an S4. What happened?
I would say band conditions shifted just a little bit because getting my antenna more resonant is not going to make me weaker generally.
Hey, okay, well, maybe you were in a dip because you're back up to about an 8 now.
Okay, cool. Have you been watching APRS.fi?
I have been sporadically. I was just about to bring it back up again.
Okay, I'm hitting plenty of beacons. I'm just on the other side of Lake Pontchartrain from New Orleans right now. Yeah, wanted to go through some different towns. I'll get on the same route when I get to about Montgomery, Alabama. And I'll be back on I-20. And pretty much parallel things, although I believe I am going to stop in Asheville for the Western North Carolina Fair and see some hams there that have an exhibit. I'm doing that...
Okay, I see that you're just northeast of Mandeville, heading toward Lacombe on 12, and you just passed Louisiana 190. I don't know if it's U.S. or Louisiana 190. Probably U.S. 190.
I would have to zoom way in on the GPS to find out. I can do that. Yeah, that's behind me a little bit. But coming up is Louisiana 434. So, did you say you sold your house?
Not quite. I said ask me in a couple days.
Yeah, I heard you. I'm recording this. I wanted to get it there for prosperity. I checked in on the... County Hunter Net on the other end of the band, and there was Jerry, KE4TTS, running counties. He was in Missouri someplace, so I worked him, but I haven't been able to get a hold of him to get on some other frequency and talk for a little while.
You'll be happy to know that your neighbors just sent an update.
Cool. I heard the beacon go off. I didn't hear a response, so it surprises me that the beacon got picked up, but I guess just because I don't hear a response doesn't mean it doesn't get heard. Maybe it got relayed by somebody.
Yeah, well, according to this, right now look, it's still moving. It's crazy. You're about 4 kilometers east of 434 on Interstate 12.
Yeah, I like the kilometers thing. The website is in Finland, and so it's got Google Maps set for kilometers, and I don't think there's a way to change that in preferences. There's a lot of other preferences you could change, but that doesn't appear to be one of them, so we have to think metric. And they did include that dead reckoning that you're seeing, where it just kind of takes the distance and the speed and keeps it going for a while until it hears the next update. I just sent another beacon, and it did not get an acknowledgement, but maybe it got picked up. And I just saw a sign for Crystal Hamburger. I'm in Crystal territory. Yay. You all know about Crystal, don't you?
Car for all your drooling.
Yeah, got a little ways to go till it's lunchtime. I'm recording this for the for video. I'll keep some of this edited in, not all of it, But for those of you on the TV audience that don't know about Crystal, think White Castle. If you don't know about Crystal or White Castle, well, I just feel sorry for you.
And if you don't know about Gary's love of Crystal hamburgers, well,
he'll eat the place until they run out of stock, give it a chance. By the way, when are you getting back in town?
Well, it's currently scheduled for Friday evening. It might not be till Saturday, but Friday's most likely.
Yeah, okay. Once you're back, I might need your help with something, you know, the old strong back, weak mind kind of help.
Did I say Friday? I'm going to be out of town for at least the next 6 or 7 weeks.
Seen an update on APERS since the 1133-20 update, which is the one I first mentioned. So I'm guessing you're probably somewhere around Interstate 59 by now and Interstate 10.
I think I'm a little bit past 59, although I don't see an interstate number on my map, but I can see the interstate back there. And probably in pretty rural territory, so there might not be a APRS digi around here. If you turn off filtering and go to look for everybody, you'll probably see there's nobody else around here either.
Yeah, it's getting kind of thin. Once you cross 59, base stations seem to disappear.
I'm going to go up on a big bridge here. Let me send a beacon when I get on top of the bridge. Maybe that can reach out and hit a digi at the distance. I got to let go of this mic, KM4NQ.
Yeah, okay. That sounds like a plan. But still, nothing is brilliant.
Yeah, a couple of beacons came back. Something should register any second on .fi.
Is this where I play the Jeopardy theme music?
If you wish. Has anything showed up?
By the way, beware of low-flying aircraft ahead.
Well, this is great. You sound like you're sitting in the seat next to me. And so far, we're channelized. Nobody has encroached on the territory. KN4AQ Mobile, Mississippi.
And W4FT, not mobile. Got to remember to do that. SEC is paying attention to caller IDs, or station IDs these days.
Getting spoiled by D-Star, which sends my ID and I don't have to say anything.
Yeah, I did it.
Well, I'm going to stop the recorder, so say goodbye to the world.
Goodbye, cruel world!
Your signal was stronger earlier when I talked to you on the County Hunter Net. Were you surprised to hear me call you?
Yes, I was.
So you said I was 5'5", and that's how I replied to you. I've heard people use that that signal nomenclature, but I don't really know what it means.
Well, generally, an F5 signal level, you know, 5x5, you know, when they get lower than that, they instead of 5'4 or 5'3, they say 3'3 or 2'2 is the minimum, and, but above 5'5 and 5'6, 5'7, 5'8, so on and so forth.
Okay. I think a 5'5 is probably the most I've ever heard. Evidently, people have a lot of trouble hearing each other. Well, it's a lot of mobiles out there, so I guess signals are usually not too super strong. So I just turned the video camera on. Where are you located again?
I am located in La Plata, Missouri.
And your reason for being there is what?
Well, there's a motel here called the Depot Inn, and they cater to rail fans. They even have a train watching channel on their TV system. But also here there is an overlook that overlooks the Santa Fe main line, the Chicago Los Angeles main line, and it's just a little cabin with a deck on the front of it and some chairs, and you can sit there and watch trains go by.
Do they have a bell and a flashing light in your room to let you know when a train is about 15 minutes away?
No, but inside the little cabin out here at the rail fan spot, they do have an ATCS monitor, which is a monitor very similar to what the railroad dispatcher uses. It shows the track diagram and shows the signal indications, I believe, for the... I think that's what it's showing, and I believe it shows the locations of the train.
And is there anybody else out there, or are you pretty much solo?
Well, I'm here by myself right now. Of course, it's the middle of the week. I imagine there's more people out here on weekends. I know that there's a barbecue grill over here, so probably some of the guys come out on weekends and grill some hot dogs or steaks or whatever and sit here and watch the train, KE4TTS.
KN4AQ Mobile. And you are listening on railroad frequency on your scanner. Have you heard any traffic?
Yeah, I don't have the scanner on right now because I'm talking to you on the radio, but yeah, I haven't had the scanner on. I haven't heard anything yet, but that's just because evidently there's nothing around. I'm not sure how Santa Fe uses their radio these days. Union Pacific, for instance, you very rarely hear them on the radio unless they're going through a maintenance area or something like that. You'll hear more radio traffic around big yards where you've got a lot of people talking to each other on different frequencies for various sundry reasons. Often the trains themselves, since they're all controlled by the dispatcher with the signals alongside the track, he doesn't need to talk to them on the radio unless something unusual is happening, like he's going to run them on a different track than they normally run on or something like that. KE4TTS.
KN4AQ, their positions and status generally then just reported with some sort of automation and data?
Yeah, that's what this ATCS system does, I think. It shows a section of track of maybe, some number of miles long, and it'll show you whatever trains are in that section.
Does that go over radio, or is that all wired so it's not really data you could intercept? Is that is released by the railroad itself and lets people watch what's going on?
Yeah, I'm not sure all the particulars. This is just something I've read that individuals can get the software and use it on their own computers. But I don't know how to do it or who to get it from or anything like that. But as far as I know, it can be done. KE4TTS.
I thought you were a real rail fan. Turns out you're just kind of a fair weather rail fan.
I'm an appliance operator rail fan.
There'll be a couple of the talks where the guy doing the presentation is talking about appliance operators, and one of them even mentions me by name.
I can understand that.
Yes, I am the king of the appliance operators. I am an appliance operator, but I'm a very good one.
Maytag, right?
Yeah, well, in my professional life, I use, at least I used to use million-dollar appliances. These days, I can afford to buy them myself.
There's a train going up here pretty quick, and then I think it's about time for supper, so
Good to talk to you,
and we'll try it again, baby.
Yeah, I should be available just about any time tomorrow, and let's see, that would be Thursday until I hopefully get up to Asheville, and then on Friday in the afternoon on the way back. So yeah, look me up. You got any more plans for being on the County Hunter Nets?
Yeah, I'm gonna be on top a little bit tomorrow. Planning on running some more. My radio just dropped out a second ago. It just cut off, so I turned the engine on. But maybe, I don't know whether the battery voltage is getting a little low or what. But anyway, I got the engine on now, so I can talk to you.
Okay. Yeah, I thought I heard a little bit of a blip. It didn't really change your signal strength much. Maybe added a half a S unit or something. My noise level has gotten very low. All that noise I was hearing from power lines went away. And so the background noise is S0, and you are about S1 to S2. And it sounds like I'm back in APRS territory, I think. I think I heard a Digipeter respond. I've been sending out beacons. So if you go look at APRS.fi tonight, you'll see where I've been. And if you correlate it to the time of day, you'll see where I am talking to you. All right, hope a train comes by soon. 73 Jerry, KE4TTS, KN4AQ Mobile. We just got done talking. It's all yours. KN4AQ Mobile near Montgomery, Alabama.
Roger, roger. HP4/WAQJA, you on frequency? WA9AAA.
Whiskey Alpha 9, Alpha Alpha Alpha, Hotel Papa 4, Whiskey 8, Quebec Juliet Alpha. Good evening.
Glad to hear you got your problem solved there with the power supply switch. The connector that was on there got so corroded.
So you might be able to tell that I have gotten off of the interstate because I just couldn't take the trucks anymore. So I'm enjoying being out here on this U.S. highway, running a little bit slower, about 10 miles an hour slower, and a little bit later night at the hotel. But it's worth it for the enjoyment of this back road without any traffic. This may be it. I will say over and out, and bye-bye.